In this video of the solid modeling basics tutorial series, we're going to continue modifying this shape here and adding some more shapes using advanced features that we haven't seen yet. So the first one here is I wanted to finish up the top edge of the pick here, and I'm going to use a sweep function to do that. And here we are going to select the top surface here that I'd like to continue up. And I'm also going to select these three edges here that are not construction edges. So I'm going to just hover over and I can see that I have the solid line selected. So I'm just going to click on those all the way around, and it brings up the sweep function. So I'm going to click sweep, and that completes the shape for me. So it just takes that top surface there and kind of bends it around that edge. This is also a separate piece right now. So it's just a separate body that will boolean back together when we're finishing up this part. The very next thing that I'd like to work on is putting some ribs around the edge of this cone. This part is intended to spin around onto the waterpick body. I want to add some little details that you could grab with your fingers to spin this part around. So I'm going to start a new sketch here. I'm going to put that on our standard plane that we've been working on so far. And I'm going to just try to make a shape that intersects the overall body here. And I'm just going to use some regular lines. I can just select here like this. I just need a little detent that kind of sticks out from the surface of this part. Nothing too fancy. And I'm going to move this point in a little bit. And I'd like to be able to move this point a little bit more precisely. And right now I'm getting grid snapping, so I'm going to turn that off. I'm going to click this grid point here, and now you can see that this point moves a lot more smoothly than before. And the other thing I wanted to do here was to just really quickly project the edge of this part down so that I knew that this sketch was behind the top surface. And I'm going to use that to anchor this sketch properly without it being floating in space. So just by clicking the project and this edge here, I now have a new edge that I can work with. And I'm going to click on that edge now and do an offset. I'm going to do an offset single. I'm just going to select this edge here. And I'm just going to offset this a little bit. We're going to make this 0.5 millimeters. And I'm going to just move these points here and connect it to that edge. That way I can be sure that it's underneath the surface and that it's pretty well constrained. So the very next thing I'm going to do here is a really quick extrude. So just looking at this surface here, I can hide my initial body. And that way I can select this inner surface. I'm going to give it a little bit of extrusion this way. We're going to do 0.5, and I'm also going to extrude this face out by 0.5 as well. So now I have a thickened rib that is going to now be patterned all the way around the surface. The other thing I wanted to do here was to quickly add some fillets that I could use. I'm going to put that into auto. And I'm just going to fillet this over a little bit. The other thing I can do is I can add fillets to these outer edges here. And I don't want this to be too big, so I'm going to do 0.3. That way it smooths out the corner a little bit. So now that I've filleted those edges, I have this separate body. And I'm going to leave this disconnected for now so that it's easy to manipulate. And I'm going to also create a pattern. So I have this node here that I can move around to help me create a pattern. And I can hover over various geometry and get that node to center correctly in different places. So right now I'm just going to select this bottom circle. And this node is now centered on that bottom circle. So I can expect this to rotate around. I have these handles here. These handles help me rotate the part and pattern the part around any one of the axes passing through this center point. I just want to revolve around this edge here. So I was just going to spin this around. I'm going to make this 360 degrees. And I'm going to pattern this around 10 times. And then finally, I have the option of doing uniform or rotation. Uniform doesn't rotate the part around the axis, it just translates it. Rotated also rotates the part. So I have that done now. And click check mark here. Now I have these ribs that pattern all the way around. Exactly what I'm looking for. The last thing I'm going to do here is to start to boolean those things together. So I'm just going to double click these big elements here and start to select union. And this also gives me the option to then come in and also union all of these elements together. So I'm going to connect all of those. Now they're all connected together. So this is now one body again. I'm going to bring this body out of the circular pattern. And the last thing that I want to do is to really focus on adding some fillets and chamfers to this design so that we can make it a little bit nicer and also consider a little bit more of the manufacturability. So first thing, going to come up here and just make a little chamfer in here. When I click this arrow and I click on an edge, I have the option of either creating a fillet or a chamfer depending on which way I pull the arrow. So I'm just going to add a little internal chamfer here. We're going to make that 0.5. I'm also going to add an external fillet here and just help make this nozzle a little bit smoother. And I'm going to make this 0.5. I'm also going to smooth out this edge. We're going to make this relatively big, so we're going to do 3 millimeters there. This part is also going to get a chamfer. Like that. I'd also really like to add a little bit of a fillet here and a little bit of a fillet here. I can also go in here and edit a fillet. So if I select that fillet, it'll give me the option to edit it. So I can do a 1 millimeter fillet there. And that way this part slides on nicely. I also want to add a little bit of a chamfer here so that when I need to plug it into the socket of the water pick, it will slide past its detents. So we're going to add another 1.5 millimeter chamfer there. That's looking good. And I also wanted to clean up this internal fillet here. So I'm going to hide some sketches so that they don't get in my way. And I'm going to fill it. This edge. That. And then there's a sharp internal corner up at the top edge here. So I'm going to give this a little bit of a fillet as well. So I can change this to 0.5, like that. So I can double check all of this by looking at the geometry here. And I can select my plane, which is the plane we've been working on. And I can also look at this section view. So now this is the cross section of that part. So I have a nice spout that goes all the way through this shape. And I've also taken away a lot of the sharp corners that might otherwise be uncomfortable or might be difficult to manufacture. But that finishes up this video tutorial for the waterpick head. In the next video, we're going to use a series of new tools to rough out the shape of the waterpick body.